Hey. Did I tell you I cut my nails? I think I did. I tweeted it. Look how short they are. This is the one that broke off all the way down to the quick, and so I had to super glue it until it grew back enough for me to cut it off and it not hurt. And so I cut all the other nails, and now my fingernails just look short and fat, and that's why I always keep my nails long. But anyway, I'm wearing Evan's hat today. I realized yesterday when we were at the laundromat that my son is so black. I mean, he's black. I'm not talking about black in color. I'm just talking about black in attitude. Like, the way, he wears his pants down low, no matter how many times I tell him to pull them up and... Yeah, I've given up on that. He wears his pants low and he wears his shirts big enough so that they'll be long enough to cover up his underwear. Anyway, so he kept walking in the laundromat because we were only washing his clothes. And, you know, he's like when my brother used to wear the wave cap, and you know, I don't know if you remember. If you're not black, you don't remember. But in the 80s, at least, the black guys used to cut their hair real short, and they would have the little short brush and use that Dax wax and comb it, and then put the rag top, I don't know what it is, then put the rag on the hair and tie it up tight. And he reminded me of my brother just because he was smoothing his hat down. You know, why? I mean, his hair is like a quarter of an inch long, so it's not like he has to fix it. So anyway, just the way he walked in there was just so black. But he told me everybody thinks he's 17 or something. But, you know, that's been years that, if he was in the laundromat, by himself, he would come out and say, somebody just asked me for a cigarette or directions to such and such a place, because he did have a deep voice even when he was, like, 13, and, it's deeper now, and then he mumbles, so, that's what it sounds like to me anyway. But I did want to tell you that, for you, I tried bacon jerky. I, thought I had seen it last week, but I thought, no, I can't possibly have seen bacon jerky, because why would anybody want to make jerky, or make bacon the texture of jerky? But it's not. It's just like, if you fry your bacon... Like, I don't like it really crispy. I don't mind if it's got a little bit of unrendered fat. Let's put it that way. I don't mind if it's all the way cooked, but I don't like it, you know, blackened or anything like that. But it's like that. It's just, like, really thick bacon. And the pieces are about 2 inches long. And it just tastes like bacon. It's good. So I tried the bacon jerky, because it was cheaper than a pack of bacon. Is there anything else? I don't know. I, got one of those, Philadelphia, you know, the little dinners that you just mix your chicken and your pasta in there, and I decided, finally... that Evan will make it for dinner, probably tomorrow. So we're gonna have the creamy garlic chicken, whatever. And I can't remember anything else. I was up all night last night. Like, I think I was up until 6 6:20, and I fell asleep, and then my alarm woke me up at 6:30 to make sure that he was awake. And then I don't remember anything else since then, after that, I mean. But I was up again at 10, and I don't know why I woke up then. Okay, I watched the first part of Neverland yesterday, and I liked the story because it was all about Peter Pan and Captain Hook. I think his name was Jimmy or James. Before Captain Hook had the hook and before Jimmy was a lost boy, Peter Pan was a lost boy. So, we got some more backstory on that. I liked it. Until he started flying, and then you can see the, green screen behind them, and, I don't remember what, channel it was on, but it got to be like a sci-fi movie. You know when they had those Mega Gator versus Mega Shark? That stupid shit? It was kind of like that, but yeah, I'll watch the second part. But I did watch Bag of Bones, which was based on a Stephen King story. And I know I have the book. It's Stephen King, so I've got it in here somewhere. But I was watching the miniseries. I don't know, it's over two nights. And I don't remember anything at all from that book. In fact, I think it's right there. I have it in paperback. I usually get them in hardback, but I got that one in paperback, and I don't remember it at all. So I'm going to have to get the book down and start reading it and see if they took anything from the book, because I really didn't remember any of it. None of it at all. I thought it was good. I liked it. I'm going to go to A&E and see, the special features and all that stuff. I have noticed a lisp that I have. I don't know why. But I hear it, and my mother came over today, and I asked her if she heard it. She didn't hear it, but Evan heard it. I don't know why I all of a sudden have a lisp, but it's getting on my nerves. I don't know what it is. What's causing this? It's not a whispering lisp. Whistling is what I mean. You know how some people when they're speaking. But anyway, so I have a lisp and it's driving me crazy, and tried the bacon jerky, that's a good thing. I forgot what else. And I'll talk to you later. That's all then.